Hello everyone, hope you found enjoying great. Welcome to Elyas Tech channel. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so happy to see you all once again. In this lecture or in this episode, we're gonna learn how we can install Ansible in our Windows 11. So before you follow this step, what I'm suggesting you to, I will definitely put this link in the comment down description as how to install Windows Subsystem for Linux. Go ahead and watch this video. It is in my YouTube channel as well. This is the procedure how you can install Windows Subsystem for Linux and our Windows 11 or Windows 10 or whatever Windows you have. Procedure is the same. It's very easy and it is very simple steps. So this is how you can install Windows Subsystem for Linux operating system. All right, so now here's the thing. What we're gonna do is at this point we need to install Ansible, one of the most advanced automation, or we can say network automation tools for a network engineer and for system engineer and for of course network architecture as well. So in order to do that, it's a very easy steps. I'm gonna walk you through to the all step. So the first thing what we're gonna do is the first step, we have to make sure that our Ubuntu is up to date. In order to install, in order to make sure that it is up to date, what we're gonna do, first you have to be in the root. If you're not in the root, my suggestion is to make sure it is root. If it's not, you can run sudo instead of if you are a different user, but my suggestion is to use root. Most of the time, most of the developer, most of the engineers, they are not recommending to use root because that for the safety purpose, but the rest is, it should be very easy and it should be very simple as well. What I'm going to do is apt-update. Let me see. I just want to make sure it's up to date. There is no any old version of anything's going on in here. And if you have a time, it is not a bad idea to run apt-upgrade as well. So I'm trying to upgrade whatever software that I have inside this Ubuntu, and in order to avoid too much error, should be very simple and should be very easy. So first I have run update and then I run upgrade. This may take a time, or if it is not, then I will pause the video, and then once it complete, I will share the rest of the command. And meanwhile, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to leave this all command in the description. Go ahead and copy from the description and run in your operating system. All right, it seems that I'm all set with the Ubuntu. apt apt at in the space ppa Right, as you look at in here, I don't have any issue. I just retyped the same thing. Probably I had an issue with the spelling. So press enter to continue. All right, it is done. So the next command is either I'm not running sudo apt install and Ansible, press enter and click Y and press enter. So the next step is that we need to install Python pipe as well to make sure that Ansible is run through the Python programming language. If you're familiar with the Python, you're the man. If you're not, that's fine, it's very simple, but this is how we can install Ansible in our Windows subsystem for Linux. Yeah, we have to wait once it's done, and we're gonna, all right, it's almost done. The last is apt-get install. Click Y, didn't ask me too much. Should I click Y or not? But Python 3, we have to install this pipe. This is the last command you have to run. apt-get install, that's why, don't ask me anything, I will accept it, Y. And then Python version 3 pipe. And of course, then we can say that libssl, and then that's for SSL certificate, and then we have to say dev and press enter. All right, it is successfully installed. In order to make sure that it is installed successfully without any issue and without any error, what we're gonna do is a very simple command, ansible dash dash, then you can see version. All right, here's the version. It looks like it is running without any issue, without any error. And this is how we can install Ansible inside our Windows, let's say Windows 11 or Windows 10, using Windows system for Linux. I hope the information was very helpful. If you think it was, the only way to appreciate my work is to simply subscribe and like the video. Until next time, I stay safe, be brave, and of course, see you guys next time.